This is the latest souring of relations between Canberra and Beijing. The Australian reporting today that two academics had their visas cancelled and at least two Chinese journalists were forced to leave the country after being interviewed by ASIO. While there's no official confirmation, it is believed that the move is linked to an ongoing investigation into foreign interference. Looking into allegations, New South Wales Labor MP Shaoquett Moselmane was the target of a foreign influence campaign. Now, this revelation comes after China reported through its state-run media that Chinese journalists in Australia had their homes raided by ASIO after two Australian reporters were effectively pushed out of China. Now, a Chinese Foreign Ministry spokesman has launched an extraordinary attack on Australia's treatment of their journalists, accusing us of harassment.
We demand that the Australian side immediately stop its brutal and rude acts. Stop harassing and suppressing Chinese nationals in Australia under any excuses, ensure the safety and legitimate rights and interests of Chinese citizens, and stop doing anything that will disturb people-to-people and cultural exchanges between the two countries.
Meanwhile, Eliza, the health minister is standing by the timeline for a vaccine rollout. That's despite that setback of the trials from yesterday.
Yeah, Pete, trials in that promising Oxford University vaccine have been halted after a participant suffered a mystery illness. Scientists are now scrambling to discover the cause of that reaction and also whether it will have an impact on the safety of this potential vaccine. Now, the Health Minister, Greg Hunt, says Australia is waiting for the results of that investigation but is hopeful there won't be a delay to the arrival of that vaccine.
They haven't changed the timeframes for any of their deliveries. For Australia, first quarter of next year remains the target and the expected and contracted date. It could be as early as January and February for the first vaccines. And so those are unchanged. But most importantly, it's about safety.
But Pete, the uncertainty over this vaccine option, the government's saying that shows why it's pursuing a range of other options. Yeah.